My name is Joan Carles Trullas, and I am a specialist in internal medicine, and I work in the hospital of Olot County, and which is in Girona, north of Spain. I am also a lecturer in the School of Medicine at the University of Vic in Barcelona, and I also belong to the Heart Failure Working Group of the Spanish Society of Internal Medicine, and I'm going to talk to you about the results, preliminary results of the CLOROTIC trial, which is a trial that investigates the different diuretic strategies. There are very few prospective trials evaluating safety and efficacy of diuretic strategies, and this is the reason why most guidelines and recommendations are based on expert opinion, because there are few randomized clinical trials. But in this context, when patients are exposed to loop diuretics chronically, some patients may present diuretic resistance, and some subset of these patients can persist with fluid overload despite you increase the doses of loop diuretics. One possible approach to overcome this diuretic resistance is the addition of a second class of diuretics, and in this case a thiazide type diuretic, but this strategy has not been tested in large scale clinical trials. For this trial, this is a randomized, double-blind, placebo-controlled trial performed at 26 sites in Spain. And we recruited 230 patients with a history of chronic heart failure, admitted for an acute decompensation, despite receiving treatment at home with oral furosemide at a minimum dose of 80 milligrams per day. And these patients were randomized within the first 24 hours of hospital admission to receive oral treatment with hydrochlorothiazide or placebo. All patients were treated with a pre-specified algorithm for furosemide treatment that was provided to all investigators to standardize its use between different sites. And in addition to this pre-specified furosemide intravenous treatment, patients were assigned to two arms. One arm was hydrochlorothiazide, oral hydrochlorothiazide, and the other side was placebo. And we wanted to test if combined diuretic therapy was superior to placebo or furosemide alone with placebo to improve the diuretic response in these patients. According to the primary endpoints, we found that patients assigned to hydrochlorothiazide were more likely to lose weight than those assigned to placebo 72 hours after randomization. And these results were statistically significant. And there was also a trend towards better scores for the dyspnea assessment for these patients. But in this case, the results were not statistically significant. We also assessed the same endpoints as secondary endpoints at day 5 after randomization. And we obtained the same results with more weight loss for the patients assigned to the treatment. Another important thing is that as a secondary endpoint, we included the metrics of diuretic response, and we observed that patients assigned to the treatment group, hydrochlorothiazide, also improved all the metrics of diuretic response. And furthermore, I think it's important that it was a safe strategy, because in the safety endpoints, we didn't see safety concerns using a combined diuretic therapy in comparison with furosemide alone. So this is, I think it's important to demonstrate efficacy, but also safety of this strategy. In patients with chronic heart failure who are decompensated despite treated with oral furosemide, we didn't know, we didn't have the evidence which is the second first-line agent, diuretic agent. Some experts recommend thiazide diuretics, but we didn't have the evidence. But now we think that at the light of these results, we have the evidence to recommend as first last line second diuretic agent hydrochlorothiazide. And maybe we can change clinical practice in this situation. I hope so. Being aware of more clinical trials with diuretics, which are really scarce in the literature, but we hope to continue this line of research and doing more research in diuretic therapy in the future.